Immunological cells need to travel throughout the body to find cancerous cells or also in infected cells or antigen. Now, integrins are adhesion molecules that allow the cells to go out from the circulation to their specific sites of action, for example, to secondary lymphoid organs. And they hold, and that's really now important, they also hold the cells at this specific place. So we are trying to understand how these adhesion molecules place within, for example, lymphoid organs or within spleen or lymph nodes, the cells, for example, two follicular dendritic cells that provide the antigen so that the CLL cell is activated and will get through the B-cell receptor signaling that drives the stimulation. So the integrins are those that hold. Now, when we have a situation that we give patients BTK inhibitors like ibrutinib or acalabrutinib or all others of these wonderful inhibitors, we see that at least the major part of the patients experience a leukocytosis. This means that the CLL cells that are located in lymph nodes are mobilized out of this protected niche by the inhibition in blood. Now, what we found together with the group of Walter Gattei in Aviano is that the CLL cells that have integrin expression that carry the alpha subunit of the VLA4 receptor on the surface, they have a higher risk of having a shortened progression-free survival under ibrutinib. And why is this the case? We believe that this presence of VLA4 gives the cells just another tool to hold in the lymphoid organs, even under therapy, and then to get still signals from the B-cell receptor and thereby have a more protective niche than those that do not have those. So we think integrins can be a means how the cells can overcome BTK inhibitors. So the research on the tumor microenvironment will have different levels of research. For example, we can look for signaling compounds in the tumor cell, but we can also see how the signaling in the tumor cell shapes the different cell populations in the tumor microenvironment. So for example, we are now trying to understand what ways are bypassing proton tyrosine kinase when we have a signaling from the B-cell receptor towards survival cascades in the B-cell, but also towards the integrin that holds it closer to other cells in the microenvironment. So understanding this interaction will give us some hints what kind of therapies we can now combine with BTK inhibitor or can give us hints what would be less toxic to the patients, because some of the side effects, for example, come from the T-cell compartment, particularly in the PI3 kinase inhibitor development. So we will learn on better therapies, and we will learn how we can tailor these therapies to the patients. So to go a step forward in direction of personalized oncology.